Hi everybody, this is Rob Halford, the Metal Guy, with my metal girlfriend, Tina B, on the Big Rock Radio Show. Turn it up. Hey, this is Vivian Campbell, and you're listening to Tina on the Big Rock Show. Hey, this is Sean Glass from the band Thursday Thing, and we're listening to Tina at the Big Rock Show. Turn it up or die. Breathe. What's up, everybody? This is JD from Black Label Society and Cycle of Pain, and you're listening to Tina on the Big Rock Show.
Welcome to Season 6 of The Big Rock Show, with your host, Tina Peak.
Oh my god, yeah!
New episodes, new music, and new interviews. For more information, check out thebigrockshow.net.
Hey folks, welcome to The Big Rock Show. I hope your summer's starting off great and that you're all getting out there to catch some cool concerts with some of your favorite bands. Now, I'm really not sure how to introduce this week's guest, because if I told you that this band consists of three football players and one guitar virtuoso, well, it might leave you scratching your heads. But be that as it may, that is exactly who makes up this hard rock slash metal band. Who am I talking about? Well, the band is called Free Reign. Reign, spelled R-E-I-G-N. And boy, let me tell you, they kick some serious ass. They've recently released their first full-length album entitled Heavier Than Metal, and the band won this year's Revolver Magazine's Golden Gods Award for Most Metal Athletes. But when you've got Black Label Society, Zakk Wylde in your corner, singing your praises, that Free Reign kicks ass, these guys will pound you into submission, and then tells you to go check them out now, well, you know you're doing something right. And I'll be joined in just a few minutes with my very special guest today, Cory Procter, drummer of Free Reign. But first, I'd like to play you the band's lead-off single. The video to this song is sick, so if you get a chance, go check it out on YouTube. I'm also going to play you another track off Heavier Than Metal called Bleed From Me, so make sure you stick around after my chat with Cory because it's killer. Now go turn it up, sit back, and enjoy. Cory will be joining us shortly, and here's the first song. It's called One Step Away, and it's by Free Reign.
Welcome to the Big Rock Show. We're going to party our tits off today. I think you know that. I know that. The American people know that. It's going to be a great program, so just go ahead and squeeze your girth and sit back and listen.
Hello?
Hi, Cory. It's Tina Peak from the Big Rock Show. How are you?
Hey, good. How you doing?
Not doing too bad. Where are you? Are you in Dallas?
Yes, ma'am.
What's shaking in Dallas today?
besides the heat, that's about it.
I bet.
It's been pretty consistent, 100 or above lately, so.
Oh, I love that kind of weather. I really do. Well, I've really been looking forward to chatting with you today because Free Reign's new disc, Heavier Than Metal, reigns supreme. It's absolutely wicked, Cory. Great job on that disc.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, we had a lot of fun. We like it.
I bet. So now tell us, how did two Dallas Cowboys, a Miami Dolphin, and a virtuoso guitarist get together to start and form Free Reign? How did the band come about, Cory?
Well, I used to be with the Cowboys, so we actually all, Leonard and Mark and I used to be on the team together. It started with Mark and I just kind of talking about music one day, and we kind of learned that both played instruments, so, and he was a guitarist and had some old bands in Chicago, and I obviously played drums, but kind of got together, us just jamming around a little bit, and eventually got Leonard aboard, and a couple of the players on the team started inviting us to play some of their charity gigs, and so that kind of sparked a little bit of playing outside, and then I think we played a Toys for Tots deal at House of Blues Dallas here one time, and that's when Justin kind of started coming in. He came to that show and liked it, and Leonard grew up with Justin in Worthen, Texas together, went to high school, played football together in high school and stuff. So Justin joined up and forced us to be better musicians, if you will. And he came in and he was, I think we're progressing well, but, you know, we're all pretty garage bandish still when he came in. And really took the time to work with us all and made us step up our game. And along that came Free Reign, and it just kind of took off from there. We've had a lot of good steps along the way and get people to help us out, especially like our producer, Alex Gerst, and good people who've helped us a lot, gotten us to where we're at right now.
Yeah, that's cool. Now, is it safe to say that everyone in the band are lovers of metal in general? Is that the musical genre that most influenced all of you?
It's actually, we have a wide variety of backgrounds.
Okay, so who would some of those influences be?
Well, like, given football and sports, metal and rock, you know, they go hand in hand. I mean, that's classic stuff you listen to before games and practice. And so it's always been a part of us. We always loved it. You got Mark, who's always been a more of a thrash metal kind of guy, big Slayer, and I think he's seen Metallica like 16 times. Leonard, actually, he likes a whole lot of Stevie Vaughn and a little more swing and jazzy type stuff.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he likes a lot more of that.
Wow.
But, he likes some metal, too. Justin's a little more newer metal. I like both. I like a lot of rock and metal, and I'm a big country fan myself.
Are you really? That's awesome.
Yeah. So, it's, but I love it both. I could sit there and listen to both of it all day long.
As long as the music's good, you're willing to listen.
Hey, yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love hearing live music anyway, whether it's a concert or it's just a small bar with a small group of guys playing. I love hearing live music. I'll sit there all day.
Yeah, same here. I'm with you on that one. All right, now, as mentioned, the band have recently released their first full-length disc entitled Heavier Than Metal. But you boys aren't just screaming and headbanging, as noted with your hit song from that disc, One Step Away, which I actually played just before our interview. It shows a real understanding of melodies and great lyrical writing, Cory. What can you tell us about that song in particular and why it was chosen as the lead-off single?
You know, we like that song a whole lot. You know, it's a little more of a hard rock song. Not as much not many screams in that one, but... you know, it's really good. It kind of fits, I guess, the image of the band. Obviously, we have the football ties, and I don't know. It just kind of, that song with the lyrics, One Step Away, it kind of signifies anyone could be at any point in life and be that one step away from, getting the raise in their job, getting that promotion. It doesn't just apply to the football field where you're, that close to the Super Bowl or making the playoffs or whatever, it can apply to everybody. So it's obviously it ties into us, but we thought it could apply to so many different people that, plus we like the song. I don't know. That's just what we ended up going with for the single, and, we like it a lot. So.
Yeah, I like it a lot, too. It's a great crossover song. Who does most of the writing in the band, or is that more of a collaborative effort amongst all of you? Like, how does that work out, Cory?
You know, it is, it's all of us. You know, we get, usually starts out with Justin writing. He has some riffs he kind of throws out there, and a lot, we do a lot of songs start over email for us because he'll come up with something and email it out. You know, I might throw some drums down to it, and Mark might come up with some potential lyrics, and he'll do a lot of writing. Him and Justin will get together for, lyrics and that kind of stuff, general ideas, and that way we kind of have a jump start when we come to a band practice. Instead of playing the songs you already know, we'll kind of have an idea of one song and try to go through it and brainstorm and see what might fit into it. But it usually starts off, our songs usually start off like 5 or 6 minutes long. They're crazy in length, and we got to bring them down a bit.
And did the writing and or the recording process differ for Heavier Than Metal compared to, say, your first disc released last year entitled Tragedy?
Yeah. It was a little bit. Tragedy, time was against us because we wanted to get in the studio. We ended up getting in the studio then, like in July, and trying to balance the whole football, the band, and the families, guys and their families. It's kind of a balancing act, but in July is usually the month where guys take vacations and get away before training camp starts in August. So you know, a bit of a time crunch to try to get the songs recorded. And with Heavier Than Metal, the full length, you know, we were able to take our time a lot more. The writing process was, I think, a lot more thought out. And I think we progressed. I think it shows in the album that we progressed a little bit in our songwriting and went, you know, as musicians, and our capabilities grew a little more. Yeah, it's just, I think we had a little more time, and I guess with what we've learned from different musicians and producers, just, I don't know, everything grew a little bit, and I think that showed.
Mm-hmm. I would agree with that. Now, Free Reign wasted no time in getting out a killer video. I have to admit, when I saw it, you guys look and sound like seasoned veterans. Was that filmed in Texas, Cory?
Yeah.
Was it?
I tell you what, that video thing came out awesome.
It did. It's brutal.
Well, a lot of credit goes out to our film guys, Jamie Brooks and his whole crew. And these guys, they're actually students at North Texas, University of North Texas.
Get out.
Yeah. And, you know, they kind of formed a small business, Third Identity. Social media guy, Vernon at Maddie Media, he kind of reached out to them. I think he used to work with them at one point and, you know, asked if they'd be interested in helping us out. And, you know, they had no problem. So we found a site to film at. There's various spots they use for the guy and the girl in the video, the actors. But as far as just the band, we did it in Terrell, Texas at Thrillvania, this haunted house, which was awesome. They gave us all their pyro. They let us do everything. We shot out in the field the first thing, and then we came back in front of the big old haunted house mansion that they had, and they let us blow up all the fire and everything. And it came out great. Everybody really rolled out the red carpet, and they helped us. It came out really cool.
Yeah, it's an awesome video. Was that storyboard idea something the band had played around with, or was that brought to the band as an idea from Jamie? Because the storyline is just so, so sad and so well done. It actually brought tears to my eyes. I'm a sap, but seriously, that is a really great video. I thought it really hit the nail.
Yeah, Jamie and his team, they actually came up with the storyline and presented it to us.
Cool.
And we loved it. You know, we always thought One Step Away was everything's at your fingertips. Well, you know, he played a little more on the sadder role of it where this guy's wife is dying from some sort of disease, cancer or whatever, and he finds a cure, but he gets there one second, you know.
Too late.
Just too late where she passes away.
Ugh.
And, you know, where he's one step away from saving her, but he saves millions in the process. So it's kind of crazy. I think it's kind of messed up in the end of the video. You know, he climbs the big old smokestack, and he sees her, and she's sitting there waving him to come up and jump. Mm-hmm. I thought that was a little messed up, but it's funny.
Yeah, well, you know, it really, honestly, I don't know how it couldn't touch anybody watching that, because we all know people who've been sick. We've all had people who are close to us die. It really touched me, and it was just so well done. I had no idea who produced it. I thought it was done by some major company. I had no idea. That's really great info. So, okay, now switching gears a bit, a couple of weeks ago, on June 11th, I believe, Free Reign played a show billed as A Night to Support Our U.S. Troops, which took place in Dallas, and I think it's terrific you guys are giving back like that. Tell us about that show and what it was like for the band as a whole to perform for all those hardworking servicemen and women.
I tell you, we had our buddy Matthew JC and his band, the JC All-Stars. He runs around and he's done a bunch of tours with his band just playing for the troops. And we can't quite get away to do that yet, but we've always loved the idea. And he presented the idea with us wanting to do a show in Dallas for the troops. So naturally, I think we're all the guys in the band are pretty are pretty patriotic, so you know, everybody jumped at the idea, and you know, we weren't sure where to go, so we talked to a buddy who is a former Marine, and he told us to hook up with the USO, and so we got hooked up with them, and they had us out to DFW Airport, where Mark and I went out and saw a bunch of troops. I think it was about 250 troops deployed from DFW to Afghanistan, and gave them CDs and T-shirts and stuff. I tell you what, the whole thing was a humbling experience. And then doing the show, which was awesome, because the thing is if you see, you know, the military come out, the veterans come out, the veteran guys, they come out, and we also, the money that we made went back to the USO to try to help them out. And the veterans were the guys that wanted to help the most. You know, we got a little jar there for anybody who wants to make donations to the USO. And the first guys up there are the veterans from the past, you know, throwing money in there to help out. So it was just really cool to see. And it rips your heart apart knowing that these guys and women, these men and women, the troops are sacrificing so much in their lives when we take so much for granted. You know, they sacrifice the time with their families to go and, I don't know, fight for everything they believe in. And it rips your heart apart a bit, but it makes you proud at the same time.
Yeah.
It's
they're sacrificing their lives for the rest of us, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I know. We're just really grateful for them and everything they do and everybody at the USO for what they do for them. So it was just awesome. I mean, it's hard to describe it because those guys are, you know, our heroes to all of us. And it was, you know, it's great.
Well, now, have the band found that social networking sites like Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube have been a huge help in getting the word out on Free Reign? Do you feel it's made a difference for you guys, Cory?
You know, a little bit. I think it's pretty standard with any bands to try to help get word out with anything that you're doing, shows or CDs or, you know, albums or whatever. But it helps a little bit. But obviously one thing we're limited to is the number of shows we can do per year right now. And I think that's one of the biggest things, getting your name out there. So, you know, we haven't been able to do that a whole lot. But as much as we can do, we got to do as little shows as we do. We have to do that much more, hopefully over the internet, and see if people grab on.
Yeah. Well, why don't we throw out a few links so folks can find the band, check you guys out, maybe take a listen to some of Free Reign's tunes that you've got up there. Do you want to throw out a few links for us?
Yeah, sure. First off, anybody can go to our website, freereignmusic.com, and we have teasers on there with the songs, and you can order a CD or shirts or anything you want. And from there, you know, we have links to the Twitter, facebook.com/freereignband, I think, but the Facebook, Twitter, MySpace, Reverb Nation, all that's there, and YouTube. You can go there and check out music videos and music and what we're up to and what's going on.
Yeah, that's awesome. And if folks want to purchase the new disc or buy some merch, they can do that through your website as well. That'll guide them to where they need to go.
That's it.
Okay.
That's it.
All right. Fair enough. And the band seems very active on Facebook in particular. I see you guys comment back to fans. You tell them what's going on. Do the band look after their own site so that it's actually one of you guys who's answering fan comments and questions? Or is that like a collaborative effort amongst all of you? How does that work?
Yeah, it's all of us trying to help out. Now, we have Vernon, our media guy, who designs the pages and, you know, because we're pretty dumb when it comes to all that. But I know how to Google something, but I don't know how to put up a design a page. But he'll design that stuff for us, and then, you know, if we have stuff to post, he'll get up there. But we all get on there and read the stuff and comment back whenever we can, and same on Twitter, so people can kind of get a little more personal experience.
Cool. Now, as busy as all of you are, the band found time to create their own label called DC Right Side Music. What can you tell us about how you came to that decision? Like, what was the reason for starting your own label, Cory?
There's a couple. I mean, one, we were with Riot Entertainment last year, and, you know, it's interesting with the, it's a whole learning process, I tell you what, from everything from being with a label to running your own label and trying to release an album by yourself.
Right.
You know, we put a lot of work into the EP, and Riot funded the whole thing, you know, so they were the ones making the money back. Well, you know, we wanted to kind of take the risk ourselves this time around, start DC Right Side Music, originated from DC Right Side LLC, which is Mark and Leonard, because they had their Smashburger line going on.
Right.
We went with Chip Ruggieri from Chipster PR, and he kind of helped mentor us through the whole release of the album and what things we needed to do, and so that he kind of led us in that direction of doing it ourselves. So if you release it on your own account, you know, you also reap your own benefits. So
true enough. Chip's a great guy. He'll lead you the right path.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's terrific.
Yeah. Yeah, we love Chip and Jen.
Oh, yeah,
everybody,
Jen.
You know, them over there, they're awesome.
Yeah, Jen's
good
a doll.
People, they do a great job, too.
Yeah, they work hard. They do a fantastic job. All right, now I'm curious, so I'm going to ask you a really silly question. You're a professional football player for the Miami Dolphins, and you're a professional musician and quite an accomplished and kick-ass drummer, I might add. So if someone told you right now you had to choose, you couldn't do both, you have to pick one over the other, which one would you choose, Corey?
Oh, man. I hate that question because both I love so much. You know, I mean, football's bringing in the funds right now, so I'd have to go with that because music can be a part of your life forever.
True enough.
You know.
Well said.
Football won't be here forever, so I'm going to have to choose that for right now.
All right. That's fair enough. That's a good answer, actually. All right. Now, we talked earlier about, you know, working in schedules and that, and I know it's got to be difficult trying to work in two very different schedules between pro football and trying to get out there to play live shows with free reign. So how are the band dealing with those issues, and are there any upcoming dates that the band are working on or anything you want to get out there you can share with us yet?
Well, I tell you, the toughest thing is especially with this lockout, everything's pending.
Right.
So, you know, we can't exactly, the Gilly show for the troops was kind of our last one for now. We don't have anything scheduled right now, any more shows. We got guys that are on vacation and trying to get ready for potential training camp that we have coming up. It's a thing. That's a tough thing with it is we don't want to schedule shows and then all of a sudden have to pull out on somebody and kind of leave someone hanging. So
right.
It's a real tough thing. So having to, you know, when the lockout wasn't occurring, it was a little easier because we knew the schedule, we knew times we could perform, and that's when we scheduled accordingly. So it's, you know, it's a little tougher right now, but it's always a battle with schedules, man. Yeah. Especially when you got four different guys in the group, and now it's just tough to do. It really is because we all have separate lives and football to deal with, and Justin has a regular 9-to-5 job and a baby girl to look after. So
yeah,
it's tough. It's always a grind. Mm-hmm. Everybody get together. That's for sure.
I believe that. So do you think they're going to settle soon?
I hope so. I hope so. You know, it's tough from what you guys, it's funny because we're reading the same thing in the news that everybody else is. So that's where we're getting our information also.
Yeah.
We get an email here and there once in a while, but it just says the same thing as the news does. So.
Yeah, I hear that.
Yeah, well, we'll see. Hopefully, I think we'll get a deal done before the season for sure. I don't think anybody wants to lose out on games or obviously a chunk of that $9 billion revenue.
Yeah. All right. For those of us who have not been fortunate enough to have seen Free Reign perform live yet, what could we expect at one of your live shows?
Oh, shoot, man. I tell you what, we kind of, we have fun with it. We try to tear it up a little bit. Mark screams the hell out of it. You know, I think he loses his voice every show. You know, it's tough, but we try to put as much energy and power into it. You know, we like playing with the lights a whole lot. This last show, Alex, our producer, actually did sound for us and made it sound killer. I mean, you know, it's just a high energy show, and we try to rip your face off.
That's what I like to hear.
As much as we possibly can.
Right on. That's what I like to hear. All right. So the band have just released a kick-ass album, Heavier Than Metal, a wicked video for the lead-off single entitled One Step Away, trying to work out some tour dates along with your schedules, with perhaps more being added as time goes. So what else is on the agenda for the band, Corey? What else can fans expect from Free Reign for at least the remainder of this year and possibly even heading into the next?
Well, for now, football is going to be taking over, you know, as the season goes on.
Right.
You know, but we'll have stuff we'll kind of release here and there during the season to kind of keep people busy and kind of keep fans interested. But, you know, after the season, we like to step into band mode a little bit. And we have some potential gigs next off season that are some big shows that might get lined up. And I can't say what they are right now, but, you know, they might be pretty cool. So we'll be announcing those in due time on the site and hopefully line up a whole bunch more shows next off season and get rip roaring and do it again.
All right. Well, now when you say big shows, are we talking perhaps festivals next season?
Yeah, festivals, maybe. We got a few that are were talking about getting on with some bigger bands. I guess they're
right on.
Yeah, I can't. I'm supposed. I was told not to talk about it too much.
But okay, fair enough. I don't want to get you in trouble.
Some bigger shows that might be pretty cool. So
okay.
We'll see.
All right. Do you think maybe you guys might also release another video at some point?
We'd like to. You know, I don't know which song we'll do. But, as much as we like the melodic songs that are toned down a little bit, we love. You know, we love the high energy ones. The Bleed for Me, the Ruins.
Oh, I love the Bleed for Me.
A little more screens. All in Vain.
Yeah.
You know those ones. We like those a lot, so we might do a little more crazy video this next time around.
Right on. All right. Well, is there anything else that you'd like to add that I didn't ask you today, or any messages for your fans out there?
Hey, shoot, just check out the music. If you like it, buy it and visit the site. Come check us out, man.
I can't thank you enough for taking this much time to chat with us today, Cory. Best of luck and continued success to Free Reign. I wish you a great season in football once it gets going. You guys are amazing.
Hey, thanks a lot. Thanks for having me on.
Honestly, my favorite new band of 2011.
Awesome.
Bar none. You guys are great.
Hell
keep
yeah.
It up and have a great
thanks.
Football season. Don't get injured.
Hey, yeah, I'm trying to come back now from one. So.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Thanks a lot. I really appreciate it.
Anytime. I'd love to have you guys come back on and, you know, maybe next year when you're doing some tour dates and you get on some of those big festival dates. I have a feeling that's probably in the cards for you guys. Then we'll have you back on the show. We can talk again.
Hey, that sounds great.
All right. Cool.
Cool. Hey, this is Cory Procter from Free Reign, and you're rocking out with Tina from the Big Rock Show. When there's nothing left
to ever break my fall. The Big Rock Show. New music, interviews, and much more. Find us at thebigrockshow.net or on Facebook, facebook.com/The Big Rock Show. The Big Rock Show, baby. Oh, yeah.